I now give the floor to Her Excellency, Ms. Solta Shaçka, Minister for Europe and Foreign Affairs of Albania.
Mr. President, Mr. Secretary General, distinguished members of the Council, let me start by thanking Malta for organizing this meeting and you, Minister, for chairing it. We are grateful to the Secretary General for his powerful words and also for his continued genuine efforts to end the war in Ukraine and, above all, for his moral clarity during this unprecedented crisis. Colleagues, this is a tragic anniversary. There is nothing to celebrate, rather everything to regret. But still, there is one crucial thing to note and never forget. Out of a disastrous war and its terrible consequences, we've seen a world remarkably united in condemning a war of choice, in refusing territorial annexation by force, in upholding the international law, and in defending the UN Charter. Again yesterday, 141 member states from all corners of the world confirmed with a resounding voice that they do not want a world according to Russia, but a world according to the UN Charter. But they want peace, a just peace for Ukraine and its people, in line with President Zelensky's peace plan. Colleagues, 1 year ago, Russian troops rushed across the borders of Ukraine and Russian missiles filled its sky, unleashing the brutal war that continues to this hour. With Russia, what Russia started on this very day last year has been cataclysmic for Ukraine, earth-shattering for Europe, history-shaping for the world. Thousands of civilians have lost their lives, millions of children have lost their schools, countless people have lost their homes, millions more have been displaced, and the damage to the infrastructure and economy of Ukraine is simply unfathomable. Millions around the world, especially the poorest and most vulnerable, have suffered greatly because of the global ripple effects, especially in the spike of food crisis. Throughout the year, the world has witnessed with dismay, has verified and documented despicable crimes, executions, rape, pillaging, torture, deportation of children, war crimes and crimes against humanity committed by the invader. We have witnessed thousands of convicts being pressed into service and used as cannon fodder in the ranks of the Wagner Group, a murderous machine with a notorious footprint in other parts of the world. And the most appalling of all of it is that an unjust, illegal and unprovoked war of aggression against an innocent country and people is perpetrated by a permanent member of the Council who bears a special responsibility for guaranteeing peace and security and for upholding the UN Charter and international law. Instead, it has chosen to behave like a rogue state, going against the law, against the rules, against the world. The truth is that despite everything, Ukraine is still here. Its people are suffering but fighting, resisting bravely in defending their land, their freedom, their future. And they are not alone. Their fight is also the fight of everyone who aspires for peace. And I have to echo, and I strongly agree with Minister Kuleba, that peace means justice. Mr. President, Russian leaders like to talk about history and their country's role in it. And Russia, of course, has much to be proud of during its history. But countries and their leaders are judged above all by their ability to learn from the past and their actions in the present. And at the present, Russia has nothing to be proud of. With its wrong actions, with its disastrous policy and its criminal war, Russia has isolated itself and it has only itself to blame for it. The sooner ordinary Russians will understand this, the sooner this madness will stop. Colleagues, this war must end, and it will end. But the end we envisage is the end of aggression, not the end of the rules-based world order. It is the end of the presence of Russian troops in Ukraine, not the end of life there. It is the end of unnecessary suffering, not the end of hope. There must be and will be a future with a just and stable peace, with a free and secure Ukraine, sovereign and with its territorial integrity restored, and we look forward to the day, and I hope soon, of the start of a process of healing and reconstruction. But until that day comes, Ukraine and its people deserve all of our political, economic, and military support, all our continued solidarity in their heroic resistance to defend themselves, to defend the rights and the just. Slava Ukraini. Thank you for your attention.
I thank Her Excellency, Ms.